तीर्थंकर महावीर यूनिवर्सिटी में यूपी और उत्तराखंड के ट्रॉपाकॉन 2019 का आगाज हुआ। तीर्थंकर महावीर यूनिवर्सिटी में माइक्रोबायोलॉजी विभाग की ओर से आयोजित ट्रॉपाकॉन 2019 में यूपी के अलावा उत्तराखंड के माइक्रोबायोलॉजी के सैकड़ों स्टूडेंट्स और फैकल्टी थे। दो दिनी ट्रॉपाकॉन का आगाज लखनऊ के SGPGI से आई प्रोफेसर उज्ज्वला घोष ने PPT के जरिए 10 अलग अलग उम्र के लोगों पर स्टडी केस दिखाए। इन केस स्टडी को लेकर परिजीवी व्यक्तियों से होने वाली बीमारियों के निदान को लाइव वर्कशॉप हुई।
See young minds like you to be participating in this Congress that delivers on different aspects of parasitic diseases. As we know, when we are moving to ahead of this 21st century, and again we are undergoing the stage of industrial evolution of 4.0 that reflects the rapid changes that is taking place in the field of big data management, Internet of Things, Artificial Intelligence, and Robotics. So all our students, whether belonging to Health Sciences, Nursing Sciences, Engineering Sciences, or Agriculture Sciences, will be definitely influenced by all the developments taking place in this field of Artificial Intelligence, Robotics, Big Data Management, and so many things. In this context, we must evaluate where we stand in parasitic disease research in India. When we think of parasitic diseases in India, unfortunately, India is a storehouse of parasitic disease. But the perplexing fact is that here, though we have lot of parasitic disease to cater, kalajar is the most devastating parasitic disease that has been taking place along the river Ganges in UP, along with spreading to Bangladesh, spreading to parts of Assam and Bihar, still being continuing in that epidemics without any sign of decrease. And this falciparum malaria, it's a major killer of the children below 5 years, still is a problem in northeastern states. And another problem is that the recent species, genotic species, fifth species, that is Rajunio nolesi. Although we are fortunate in India, till now there is no official case documentation of Plagiunio nolesi from any part of the India, it is strongly believed it may be possible in the northeastern parts of India. We must be prepared to receive this disease, and we must have strategy how to manage this disease. Unfortunately, in field of microbiology or tropical diseases, as my earlier speakers have right.
Malnutrition, as we all know, we have seen malnutrition, high population density, water scarcity, low health status, and lack of personal hygiene are one of the major causes of this, especially the intestinal infections. The parasitic diseases are prevalent throughout India. You go to any part of the India, especially in the more in the wherever there are more socially backward people, you will find a lot of parasitic infections, especially the intestinal infections. Now, even in the, for example, the vector-borne diseases also, there you will find malaria is one of the very important causes of parasitic infections. But the reporting is always underreported because of various reasons. That is why probably We have got a problem of formulating new policies, how to control the programs, because most of these diseases are underreported. For example, I'm in Aligarh, I'm in AMU. There you will find it's not a very big place, it's a small place, but the amount of reporting is very limited. We don't report to the authorities the incidence rate. There may be hundreds of labs and hundreds of nursing homes. In Aligarh, I'm not talking about Delhi or Lucknow or anywhere else. But where do we report? We don't report anything. That is why probably the if you see the epidemiology, you see the prevalence rate, it is far less than actually what is happening. Especially you go to, in our medical college, you'll find lots of patients of malaria. But we don't report.
Most of these will be either antibiotic or virology. There will be very little or no discussion about parasitic disease, or even for that matter, tropical parasitology or any parasitic disease. So I was feeling this, and it was at the same time. I was thinking all this, it was same time. Eminent parasitology of this country who is sitting here, that is Dr. S.C. Parija. He is a very eminent figure in this field. And I came to know that he is organizing a first India conference of the Indian Association of the Tropical Parasitology in Chennai. So I went there and I met him. And so I have a long association with him for around more than 15 years or so. And gradually the first conferences were very good, and I learned many things, met a lot of people in this field. Then IITP was like trying to make a state chapter, so it was then I decided that in the UP we don't have any forum. Leave aside the Indian scenario, there was nothing there also, and as I told, and even UP, there was, even in the UP we had this IMM UP chapter that was formed by us at ZPJI only 2003, but also that is a very one day conference. And
other learned people from microbiology and allied fields, dear students and delegates. We all know, especially in Indian philosophy, the devil resides in garbage. And that's the problem with all these vector-borne diseases. There may be some medicinal, what you call, remedy from the attack of these parasites or the vectors, but the problem is something somewhere else. Since I'm not coming from the field to majority of you belong, but I come from a field which all of us belong. The mankind, the human, the environment, and more is the value and ethics and preservation of the climatical conditions or ecological system. When it comes to understanding the requirement of creating chemicals or something of similar nature, it is more on what you call corrective and reactive aspect than the promotive and preventive aspect of things. If we are looking for lesser cost of medications and treatment and healthcare, our focus needs to be more on to creating conditions of a healthier ecosystem around. If you look into all developed nations, and I was just sharing with Dr. Jain when we were there in the same row sitting, that if you look into the country like Singapore, do you find these type of problems? A small country.
Vice Principal Medical College and HOD Department of Anatomy, Professor S.K. Jain, Professor Umar Farooq, Professor Ujjala Ghoshal Ma'am, and my teacher, Dr. Haris M. Khan, and Dr. Sudhir Singh. It is indeed a moment to reckon with for Teerthankar Mahaveer Medical College and Research Center in general, and Department of Microbiology in particular. I appreciate the efforts of Professor Umar Farooq, who took the lead and worked hard to organize this conference along with his team. I am very much confident that this occasion will serve its purpose abundantly, and all the delegates will enjoy not only the academic feast, but also the opportunity for fellowship. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Wish all the best to Tropacon UP UK chapter 2019. I would not like to take much time because the session is open, and I wish everybody and my dear students to go ahead in this field. Thank you very much.